Mr. Gruber, I've been accused that I'm going to berate you or something, and I hope that you won't feel that way when I get done. But night before last, I was at the Kennedy Center Honors, where they honored Tom Hanks, famously Forrest Gump, the ultimate in successful stupid man. Are you stupid?
I don't think so, no.
Does MIT employ stupid people?
Not to my knowledge.
Okay. So you're a smart man who said some, as the ranking member said, some really stupid things, and you said the same. Is that correct?
The comments I made were really inexcusable.
Okay. And I'll leave aside the political observations, but you did say in your in the video we played, and everyone else has seen, I think, parts of it, you did say that, in fact, if people knew the whole truth, they wouldn't have voted for this, that in fact the direction you were going, the reality, and specifically I want to talk, because Mr. Goldman's a poster child for this. He has a silver plan that is relatively inexpensive. If it was subsidized, it'd be even cheaper. But the shifting of some people to pay more than they previously did, because remember, health care went up in price. So for Mr. Goldman to get a reduction, somebody else got not only an increase, but an increase to offset his decrease. That was what you were talking about. So isn't it true that, in fact, between the taxes and increases for some, that's part of the plan to reduce for people like Mr. Goldman?
First of all, I made a critical mistake in trying to conjecture with a tone of expertise.
Yeah, no, but you're an expert on the analysis of the numbers and where the cost shifting goes in your microeconomic analysis. And I'm asking you as Dr. Gruber, a smart man, a smart man at a great institution that has collected over over $4 million in various fees and so on. Your analysis, isn't it true that in order for Mr. Goldman to get his reduction, and he's very happy about it, that in fact there was cost shifting, including those so-called Cadillac plans? Isn't that true?
The Affordable Care Act set up insurance exchanges which pooled risks for the healthy and the less healthy. On average, when you account for the tax credits individuals received, people are paying less for health insurance than they
would. I'm a taxpayer, Mr. Gruber. Trust me, people are not paying less. People like me are paying more for those because taxes are, in fact, a cost that's paid. Total cost did not go down. Cost shifting occurred in your model. Isn't that true?
The amount that individuals have to pay for health insurance, on average, fell in my model.
Well, but it didn't fall in reality.